It's a tough 4-3 loss here to Northern Michigan. Can we get your initial thoughts on today's contest?
Yeah, my feeling was it was really a good hockey game. It was what I anticipated coming in. I thought both teams played really hard. The compete level was very high. Very few real mistakes. Mistakes that were made were caused by the other team, applying pressure. So, all in all, I thought it was really good. Obviously, 3-3 late, the 5-minute major. I didn't see it, so I can't comment on it. But, boy, I was really proud of the ways the guys killed that. I was really happy. I did see the 2-minute call for delay a game. I got to be honest, I'm a little bit, I question that one. And we just killed the 5-minute. Our guy got cross-checked down on top of the puck, and I don't know. That one, that was kind of a – it was just one too many in a row there. Even then, we got back. We put it in our own goal, and it was no one's fault there. We just tried to intercept the pass. It hit our defenseman stick and went in. But, in a game that's that close, things like that make the difference.
And can you talk a little bit about Nate Callens play tonight? He had his first 2 goals of the season. One was a power play goal, and he looked good.
Yeah, Nate played very well. I thought our power play, with the exception we had one power play in the second where we had a hard time getting in the zone, but I thought our power play looked very good tonight. I thought our penalty kill, even though they were 2-for-5, I thought our penalty kill was very solid. Really not too disappointed. I'll have to watch the video. There's not many things that, I looked at, I could say, hey, we made errors or made mistakes. It was just two pretty even teams going at it, and tough loss.
And what was your opinion on how Roney played tonight here? And he allowed 4 goals with some tough shots he faced.
Yeah, like I said, we knocked the one in. You can't blame him on that. So overall, I thought he played a good game. I did. I thought both goaltenders played well. I don't know what the shots were. I guess it was 35-26 us. But I don't think the shot totals, even though they're not overly inflated, I don't think they tell the tale of the quality chances both teams had.
And then, Coach, I just thought, you go up 1-0 and then they get 2 goals, but you responded. They went up 3-2, you responded again. How important is that to have those quick responses to keep you in the game?
Yeah, great question. It was really important, and we responded pretty quickly too. It wasn't like, so I really like the makeup of this team. And we for the most part, I thought we did a great job. We stayed off the officials. We stayed focused on task, which I felt at times last year we didn't do that. I thought we would get distracted, and instead of, digging in and trying to get the equalizer. And even then, we were a pretty tired group by the by about the last 3 minutes when we finally were even and we needed to make a push, because killing what 6 minutes, and then we lost 19 Oscar when he got the 5-minute major. So all of a sudden we had to go to 3 lines. We overplayed guys on the penalty kill. They happened to be a lot of the same guys on the power play, and I think the guys, we still had some pushback, and I was real proud of that. But it's hard to generate offense when you're tired.
And then just with conference play starting here, is it, it looked pretty physical out there. Can you just kind of discuss the level, the competitiveness, the focus that we're now in conference play? Is it just rise up that level?
Yep, it sure does. Good, right on the money where there. It was, everything from the physicality in terms of hitting, but also just the battles for loose pucks. Both teams, I thought, were tenacious on that. I thought both teams were heavy on their sticks. At times, the play looked a little sloppy, but I think that's just the aggressiveness of the other team, them and us, on the forecheck and so forth. There wasn't, everything was happening very quickly out there, and there's not a lot of room for bobbled pucks. And so at times it looked a little sloppy, but I think it was, I thought it was a very good hockey game for this early in the year. And you're right, you can see conference play. We have a physical league. It is. It's a very physical league, and you can see it tonight.
And then last question, I know it's the game's just ended, but off the top of your head, what are some adjustments you'll have to make and just some of the things you're going to have to execute tomorrow to get a win?
Well, I wasn't really particularly happy with our face-offs tonight. I You know, it's been a thing, you know, while it's early in the year, but it's been a trend already that we're losing more faceoffs than we're winning. Consequently, we start a lot of shifts having to chase the puck and get it instead of starting with possession. So, you know, that's not necessarily always the centers either. It's around the faceoff circle, getting in, helping the center. Because a lot of draws, I would say maybe at least half, end up almost neutralized or tied up, and then it's the next team that gets in and mops up that loose puck like a fumble in football, if you will. You know, it's you got to be on top of it. The puck's loose, it's up for grabs. And I thought they did a better job than we did on that.
Coach, 16 block shots, 11 coming from your defenseman. How impressed are you with your team putting their body on the line to help Salmon Kangas?
I thought we did a great job of shot blocking. We the D obviously did a really good job, but I also, there was in the first period, Oscar had a big block as well as Hunter went. And we lost Hunter for probably at least half of the first because of that block, but he's fine. But, you know, they wanted to make sure he was okay. But it was, you know, I thought overall that the team did a good job of playing well in front of Roney.